Today, I want to talk about the 10 biggest reasons why we feel demotivated. Let's start with the biggest thing: work out. We feel proud after we worked out, we feel happy, there are happy hormones going on in our body, and this is the state of mind from which we really want to get stuff done. And of course, there is the happy bonus of weight control, blood sugar and insulin control, and fighting heart disease, which you really can't beat. The second thing is sleep. I think everybody knows that sleep is important and that after a night of disturbed sleep, we tend to underperform, but maybe not everybody knows that sleep is vital to cellular restoration, including our muscles, our tissues, our hormones, and not just that, but our mental capacities are restored and improved during sleep, things like our memory and our focus. So we need to make sure that we get good and sufficient sleep. The next thing that we need to do is get good food. Food is pretty much one of the few things that we can control about our body, right? We can't tell ourselves what to do. We can't tell our organs to be healthy, but we can influence them. There are, for example, deficiencies like vitamin B6 deficiency and iron deficiency, where you can really feel lazy and tired, and if you don't know better, you can blame it on yourself and feel bad. But actually, it's really all about your food. So if you're eating well, you are going to feel well. The fourth thing is water. Drink good as well, because if you want to absorb those nutrients, those minerals, if you actually want to get the benefits of them, you need water in your body. Our body is pretty much mostly water. It's in our blood, it's between our organs, it's cushioning them, it's in our brain. So we need water for pretty much good sleep, for workouts, for food, all of the other vital functions. If you take care of your basic needs, if you take care of your body, you will have a very good foundation to work on yourself, on your projects. But then there are more things that you can do. For example, making sure you spend enough time outside. Not only is this good for your vitamin D regulation, the light tells your body when to sleep, when to feel tired, when to feel awake. It is also good to get fresh air, but there is also the whole nature of being outside. It's a non-sedentary activity. It's oftentimes a social activity. So this is something that will get you to move, to be with people, something that will activate you. The sixth reason why we feel demotivated is due to a lack of clear set goals. Goals are like roadmaps. They get us from one place to the other, and then they give us this destination that we need to reach so that we can put our energy towards it. See if you can define your goals. Know where you have to go, because if your goals are too vague, you never know when you reach them. You never know what you should exactly do. You know, maybe I should find a new job, but it's not the same as I should learn English so that within 2 years I can find a job in copywriting. This is a goal that is very exact. You know what to do. So you can sit down and actually make this a project, write down your milestones, and it's something that motivates you, something that you will know when you achieve it. When you're at the new job, the new copywriting job, you will know you're there. The seventh thing that makes us unmotivated is a lack of clarity. You really need to sit down and think about your goal. What can I do every day to get this done? And it can be many things. In the example of learning English, you could be writing essays, you could be with your teacher, you could be learning words. So you could write these things down, and every day you will take one of those things, you will do it. You don't have to wake up and have this decision-making process, which is sometimes very tiring for your brain. Try and make a few to-do lists, or at least have some kind of calendar plan so that you have at your disposal an array of things you can do that given day, predefined. The eighth thing is being stuck in your head. And it is awesome to be able to be with yourself and with your thoughts for a long time and be okay with that. But this is also the place where you can start your negative thought patterns, your negative self-talk, things that really should be interfered with. And it really helps sometimes to listen to other people, listen to podcasts, listen to your friends, just to make sure that you are always looking at things with a fresh mind, that you are not stuck in the same place that you are. Of course, meditation practice helps. This is a great way to get out of your head, but you don't even need to go that far. I think already just being in nature, going outside, can get you out of your mind and a little bit into the world. Exercise is also a great way to get into the present moment because you don't really have time to think. You are moving your body and you are getting that proud of yourself feeling, you are getting those endorphins. It is generally a good way to be out of your head and to be motivated. The ninth reason we feel demotivated is due to lack of human contact. I think the biggest thing here is if you are talking to other people, you hear new ideas, but not like when I tell them to you. You hear a real person in your life, it just feels much more real, much more relevant to your situation because they know you, they are where you are, you have a little bit more background on them, and just hearing their stories, hearing what they're doing, it can inspire you, it can give you ideas, and it can get you out of this thing that is often perpetuated on the internet, which is comparing yourself to others. And the last thing that we can do about demotivation is staying off of social media for a bit longer. As I said, comparison is often something that is toxic from social media, not because it is in general bad to compare yourself to people, it is, but those people on social media you have so little background knowledge about that you are comparing yourself always on unfair terms, whether it is to their best self, to their worst self. You only know this part of them, so you are always on the losing side because you know everything about yourself. And I want to give a few honorable mentions to things that demotivate us, specifically to toxic people. I think being around people that are not making us happy, that are draining us, is something demotivating. Even though they might be your friends, they might be your family. Another thing is not doing what you love. I know you could compare yourself to someone at their dream job while you're doing just the job you're doing to get by money-wise, and it could look like they're so much more motivated than you because they are a harder worker, because they're smarter, because they're better at their job. But don't underestimate what doing what you love does to your motivation. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you got this far, I feel terrible about what's going on in the world right now, and I feel demotivated, I feel sad and heartbroken, and I just wanted to give you this little bit of hope so that we can treat the cause, so that we can motivate ourselves to make our world better. I want you to have hope because all is not lost. I'll see you next week.